Hi there, welcome to this episode of Hacker Rank series. If you're a new viewer, please subscribe to my channel, and if you're returning, welcome back. Let's look at the tech strap. This is an interesting one, and it just needs a bit of thinking. I've got a JupyterLab on the right side that will help to explain things a bit easier, and I've got the Hacker Rank dashboard on the left. Let's look at the task. You're given a string S and width W, so if you open the execution part, well, if you don't know what is the execution part, that's what I like to call this little bit down here. This is where we perform all the actions that we have prescribed up here. So let's call this up here. This is the recipe. If you were making a pizza, you would write up the recipe for making that pizza, bring all the ingredients, but down here is essentially putting it in the oven and making it become a pizza. You're given a S string that comes from the user input and gets saved into the string, and also you receive a width value. I will get back to what it is. Your task is to wrap the string into a paragraph of width W. So let me quickly copy this bit down here. Let's call it a string and give it the characteristics of a string. And also we will receive a number 4, and let's call that max width, which is 4. What the task wants us to do is to take this longer string and this number 4 and print that bigger string in chunks with length 4. So A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, and so forth. That's what we're planning to do here. If you are familiar with the range function can go from, for example, 0 to 10, if that was the case. We can't really see it unless we convert it to a list. You can see that 0 to 10 runs from 0 to 9 because it never includes the last bit. So if I write that to the length of the string, you will see that because the string is the English alphabet that runs from 0 to 25. What I really need to do is to be able to run one more over that, so to 26. You will understand why I'm doing it. So running from 0 to 26, this is really good. The other important thing about the range function is that you can provide steps. You don't have to do every single one of them. You can provide steps. What you can say is, you can say, hey, give me every 4th element. So that gives you 0, gives you 4, 8, 12, and so forth. So what I want to put here instead is the max width. So same, but I just want to make sure I'm working with variables. So now that I have this, I think I can easily start looping over the string like this, for I in, I'll copy the range bit. I only used the list because otherwise I wouldn't be able to see this. So let's do this. And if I print I, you will see that I'm printing the same thing. But the good thing about this is that I can bring this string and break it into chunks from 0 to 4, 4 to 8, 8 to 12, and so forth. So let's make a new variable called chunk. And the chunk is from this string, and it runs from I all the way to I plus max width. Did I type it right? Yeah, I did. And if I print chunk, you will see what I'm doing. I'm printing A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, and so forth. So let me get rid of this cell. What if I make this 5? Did it work? Yes, it does. But the fact is that this is not going to be enough because printing the chunk is okay, but I want to be able to return it into the function, which is my recipe, and then perform the execution part. I need a return bit here. What I can do, I can say, hey, look, as long as you are within every 4th element, so the length of this is dividable by your max width. So that means that I'll have to say, if the len of chunk, so if the length of this chunk equals your max width, keep printing the chunk. So you will see that now I am not printing, hang on, let me run this with four. Yeah, I just wanted to make it four. I'm not printing the YZ at the end because this is 26. Now, I'm happy with what I have for ABCD, EFGH, all the way to UVWX. You may ask, so what are we gonna do with YZ? And we could see it before anyways. There is a problem. We need to use the return so that this function returns something into the result through this bit, and we can print that part, the very last part. All we need to do is to use else and pass for now. What I will do, I'll copy this here and make sure it is indented. I will do the very last bit here. I will say return chunk here. So why I did this, when we call the wrap function, which is this top one, let's start over. We receive a string from the user. We receive the max width. So we have A, B, C, D, E, F all the way to Z. And the max width is 4. So then we call the wrap function, which is all of this. And we send string and the max width to the wrap function. What happens when we call the wrap function, it will continue printing until UVWX. And when it gets out of dividables by 4 and we are left with Y and Z, it will say, okay, if whatever you have that is left does not equal the max width, then return the very last bit. And that allows us to print YZ at the very bottom. So let's hope this is gonna run. If it runs, hit the like button, subscribe to my channel, and that really encourages me to build more content for you guys. Let's see. Yeah, it did run. Let's submit it. All the test cases passed, and we just scored another 10 points. I think I'm only 5 points away in this dummy account that I've made to get my fourth star for Python badge.